Are we virtually enslaved by the Federal Reserve?
Well, the Federal Reserve is determines interest rates. It sets the money supply. It sets the money worth. And if we're having money troubles economically, then yeah, we definitely need to all turn and look at the Federal Reserve system. What this is doing is running up more and more debt, and the whole problem that we're in right now is because of debt. So they're piling more debt on top of this debt. This is a very carefully crafted plan to destroy the worth of the U.S. dollar and to crash the U.S. economy.
Would that be to usher in a euro-like currency called the Amero?
Yes. Once people are so panicked because the money is worthless, then there'll be calls to combine the economies of Mexico, Canada, and they will be ushering in the Amero, which will be similar to the euro, and they'll be buying up our worth at 10 cents on the dollar.
Ready to go right into Israel.
The biggest bone of contention in the founding of this country was, do we need a central bank? And by 1830, after a couple of attempts, they said, no, we don't. And we didn't have one until 1913. Then we got what was pushed through a unknowing and unaware Congress was a banking reform bill. And what it did was create the Federal Reserve, which now is even the mainstream media has acknowledged as being our central bank. It was thrust upon us as a banking reform bill. And instead, what it did was exactly what Thomas Jefferson warned us against. He said, if you ever allow bankers to gain control over your money supply, our descendants will wake up without property in the country that we founded. And that's exactly what's happening.